welcome to Sebastian River Area Chamber of Commerce Candidates Forum. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Beth Mitchell. I'm the president of the chamber, representing the board of directors. We'd like to welcome our participants tonight, particularly the Fellsmere City Council, for giving us the opportunity to hold a forum here in this beautiful auditorium. We'd also like to thank the candidates, not only for participating in the forum, but also for making a commitment to the community by deciding to run for a city council seat. Before I introduce our moderator, I'd like to introduce each one of the candidates. And in alphabetical order, we have four candidates who are seeking one of three positions on city council for a two-year term. As voters, you will be selecting three of these candidates. Mr. Michael Barone is not here tonight, if he does decide to join us sometime in the evening, we'll invite him up on stage and we'll save his questions for him. Next to introduce is Mr. Fernando Herrera. He's currently the mayor pro tem of the city of Fellsmere, seeking his, how many years?
11 years.
11 years, okay. And sitting next to him is Ms. Jessica Solgado. She's new to the political scene and she starts seeking her first term as a council member. And then finally, Joel Tyson, who is currently the vice mayor, although he has served as the mayor and the mayor pro tem and several other positions.
Dog catcher.
Whatever. Joel, how long have you been serving the city?
I don't know. I can't remember. First got elected in 98, and then, I was on there for 1 year. I resigned and ran for mayor. Mayor for 2 years, and then was out for a year, and then I came back in for 2 years, and then I was out for another year. So, off and on since 98 is about the easiest way to put it. Actually, Fernando is the longest continuous serving. He's had to interrupt it.
Okay.
So I make a mad at
him. Well, he's in the longest. I think he has served more than us.
Okay. All right. Well, this forum is sponsored by the Chamber, and it's another example of our service to our communities. And we provide an opportunity for an exchange of information for the benefit of the voters. And here's how the forum is going to work. The candidates have chosen numbers, and they're actually seated in the right order, and that will determine who goes first. We have a set of questions for each candidate, but before we give them their questions, we're going to give them 2 minutes for opening statements. Then each candidate will have their own set of questions, and then after that's over, we'll have another 2 minutes for closing statements. I'd also like to introduce our timekeeper for the evening, Maggie Sammons. Maggie is the owner-operator of Custom Air Systems here in Fellsmere, and she's also a longtime chamber board member. Maggie has two battles, okay? One that shows you have 30 seconds left in time, and then the red one, which means that your time is up. Do you have any questions? No? All right, let me bring our moderator for the evening up, Ms. Theresa Tolle. Theresa is the owner-operator of Bay Street Pharmacy up in Roseland. She's a vice chair of the Sebastian Chamber. She's also the chair of our Legislative Government Affairs Committee. So please help me welcome Theresa.
Thank you very much. It's an honor for me to be here, and I love the building and the auditorium. It's beautiful. So are you guys ready to get started?
Absolutely.
Yes. Okay. All right. So Mr. Herrera, 2 minutes for an opening statement, please.
Okay. Well, my name is Fernando Herrera. I've been here at City Council for 11 years. I've been here a resident for 42 years. And a lot of that I was only 15 years when I came here and brought mom here. So I love City Council and I love the people. The most important thing I like to do for citizens is a lot of respect in our community.
Okay. Jessica, or Ms. Solgado.
Well, my name is Jessica Solgado. I've been living, sorry, I'm just a little sick today, so I can't speak that loud today. But I've been living in the city for 10 years. This is like my first year running for city council. I'm moving. So everything's new to me. I'm learning everything. So hopefully I'll answer the questions as good as possible.
All right, thank you. And Mr. Tyson.
And the four of them last Saturday night, the lady asked me, she said, you've been on there a long time, how come you want to keep on serving? And I told her about a guy that was on the school board. He was there for 17 years and said he had unfinished business. And I thought, well, if you can't finish it in 17 years, then you need to give it up. But I don't have any unfinished business. I think we've done well in finishing most of our projects and so forth. But we do have some ongoing, what we call work in progress, and projects that are coming online. The National Elephant Center is one we're trying to bring in. The natural gas pipeline is another biggie, which will trigger the shrimp farm, the aquaculture project out west of town. We've got the Dollar General store coming in, and there's a possibility of another restaurant opening with a retail space. So these are ongoing things, and I think those are all good things for the city. And we have a good team. Right now with the council, we work well together. We work well with Jason. I think everybody respects the duties of our staff. They're supervised by Jason. We don't get involved in the day-to-day operations. So I just would like to keep things rolling. If you have enough faith in me, although I'm 80 years old, I think I still have enough energy to keep on trucking. So thank you.
All right, thank you very much. Okay, so the second part of our forum, each candidate will get 5 questions, and you have 2 minutes each to answer those. Mr. Herrera, technically you're candidate number 2, so you're going to get the questions that were randomly assigned to candidate number 2, okay?
Okay.
So here we go. Question number 1, please provide a list of priority issues that you feel the city should focus on.
Well, I'd like to see more fields for the children to play soccer on the field. I'd like to see that in the future for more. And now we have to do this, what we have right now. And I know the economy hurts on that, and that's going to be really tough. But we're going to move forward to continue to kind of give us fields for the children to be able to. But that's one of them. I'd like to do that. And I'd like to do other things like the veterans, senior citizens, have a facility for them one day. So that way they can gather together and just enjoy the day. That's my focus, probably.
Okay. Anything else?
That's it,
okay. All right, number 2. In your role as city council member, what do you think your biggest contribution will be to this community?
Big contribution? Like what, you might give more detail for this?
So, how have you helped the community? I mean, you've been serving, we've already heard, the longest continuous. So, what have you done to help, or what will you continue to do to make Fellsmere a better place?
Well, I work with the residents, on people, someday they got issues and concerns about the place, they want to come to the city council and bring their concerns. A lot of times, for them not to go, I will share with them, listen, you have the right to come to the city council, go with your opinion, but a lot of times you don't need to do that. You just need to go to the city manager or the mayor and get some answers and your problem solved. And that's the way it works. There was one time when there was going to gather about the water issue, there was a concern that the water wasn't that great. And I shared with them, hey, we're working on that real hard on it, and it's going to be solved. So you don't have to go, but you have the right to go. And they said, no, okay, then there's no problem, it's fine. And I share that with all the time. Little things I can help to help them. And I will continue doing them. A lot of times there's something personal. And I don't know that power help them solve the problem and move along. And that's it. And I share with them the issues they have, which I'm going to be moving on.
Okay. volume out there. You can hear me? Okay.
Can you hear me?
I need to make them speak up a little more. Okay.
So not that I don't want you to look at me.
No, that's fine.
I think I should have you address your citizenry and just speak louder.
Okay.
I just want to make sure they can hear you.
Yes. So. No, that's
all right, should I make him repeat the answer?
Then I got to get ready.
Okay, so question number three. Many cities around our nation are going bankrupt because they cannot handle their employee benefit obligations. What plan do you have for the future to ensure that salaries, benefits, and retirement plans of city employees do not overburden the budget of the city's taxes?
Well, we have a wonderful staff in the city of Larry Neighbor. He does a great job on doing that. I think that Larry Neighbor has done a good job for our city. He's staying focused on his work. He does a great job. I don't think we're going to have that problem. By him being with us, I don't think we're going to have that problem.
Okay. All right, question number four. Can you explain the difference between a strong mayor form of government and a city manager form of government, and which one works best and why?
Well, city manager, we have a city manager today. Been here with us 7 years. And having a mayor, a strong mayor, if they work as a team, we can be very successful if we have. I know there's a difference, but city manager that we have today, he's staying top on the work. And as long as we have this mayor, Susan has done a good job too. You know, she stays on top of it. And I know we find myself a lot of times the same question. But how could I put it this way? Jason has done a lot of grants given from the state, and that's why we are today with the grants we've been given for the city. If it wasn't for that, I don't think the city won't be that big. We won't be able to get the grants we've been given from the city.
Okay, good job. All right, and then the final question for you. How would you balance commercial development while maintaining the historical feel of Fellsmere?
That's a good one. I don't know how to answer that one.
So commercial development versus historical. How do you keep both in balance, or how do you keep both?
I'm going to have to pass on this one. I'll pass on this one.
Okay. You're going to pass on this one. Okay. All right, so you're through with your questions.
Yes.
Your last part will be your closing statement, okay? And we'll get there after I go through the others. All right, Ms. Salgado, question number one. What do you feel is the biggest weakness in the current city council that you hope to change by being elected?
I don't see any weakness right now because they've done a great job. I've seen new projects, work well with Susan, so I don't think they see any weaknesses right now. Just, I mean, maybe grow, but no weaknesses.
Okay. Question number two. In business, a financial statement includes revenue and expense information. Can you list the different sources of revenue that the city of Fellsmere receives?
Right now, I don't have an answer for that because I'm not really into everything. And,
okay. Question number three. You'll be able to answer this one. What issues motivated you to run for this office, and what do you plan to accomplish during your term?
What motivated me is I think that it was time for the next generation to step up for, you know, to see what they want in the city for the future. And I think that one of the things that I would love to see here in the city would be more things for the kids, for the youth, so that way they can have more activities and, you know, they're not in the streets. And something that families can together do, like, for instance, like having gardens, that way, you know, the kids can learn everything and the parents, you know, there's something to say. You know, family orientation, so.
Okay. Question number four. How would you define going green, and how should Fellsmere address this issue? So basically, recycling, that type of stuff.
Well, I think that we do a lot of recycling, so that would be one way. There's different ideas of, you know, having like gardens. I think that one thing would be like growing their vegetables, or having like their farm with, you know, their animals. That would be one way, and that way the people get more into it, get involved.
And one thing I forgot to mention is at the end in your closing statement, if there's a question that somebody else got that you think I have a great answer to that, feel free to address that in your closing statement as well. And then finally, your final question, number five, are you satisfied with the redevelopment efforts in the city's CRA district, and what further improvements would you like to see the city accomplish?
I think so far we're going in a good direction as to what we want to see in the future for the city. So, I mean, we're getting there. So.
Okay. And any goals for the future?
I think more recreational things.
Okay. Then we're going to move on to candidate number four, Mr. Tyson. Your first question, why are you the right person to address the difficult economic challenges that face the city?
I don't think we've got any difficult economic challenges. Personally, we've done very well financially. We're kind of coasting along now on our development fees from SunAg. We annexed them a few years back, and then with the grants that Jason gets, we're able to pave the streets. We're applying for a grant to put the gas line out to the industrial park. We've been very, very fortunate in getting the grants to help us. I think we're doing so well that I think we were the only city in the county that gave our employees a pay raise this year. So I don't see that we're having any. We may, starting next year, if things don't pick up, there may be a problem.
Okay. Question number two. How would you encourage redevelopment in the Old Town District?
I think what we need to do is advertise the fact that we've zoned that as an Old Town district, that they can't come in and build any modern structures. It has to conform with the style that's already there. There's land that's available there, and there again, if we get the hotel open, that's going to be a step in the right direction. I know that yesterday I was talking to Stan Disbys, who owns the old post office building. He's putting an antique store in, and I think some of the things that we need in there to enhance the Old Town district is maybe have, if somebody would open like an ice cream parlor or a candle factory and things. There's a town over in the center of the state called Lake Placid, and they've done things like that. And they brought back, actually their old town, they brought it back alive by people coming in and taking a chance to do it. Of course, that was back during the time that the economic boom was going on and they were able to do it. So there again, these are some ideas that we need to keep on the back burner, so that when the economy does pick back up, we can promote those types of activities.
Okay, thank you. Number three, what are the issues and projects that the cities of Sebastian and Fellsmere have in common, and how should they work together on these issues?
One of the issues is the gas line coming in. I was invited to go over to a meeting there, but it's probably been 3 years ago, where they were talking about converting their vehicles over to natural gas. And they were talking about, Sebastian was talking about trying to bring in a natural gas pipeline with possibly a filling station out about County Road 510, where Fellsmere and the city of Sebastian could share that. So to me, that right now, that is the biggest mutual project that we can both benefit from.
Okay. Question number four. Do you have any ideas on how the city's economic development plan should be implemented?
I'm running out of voice.
Okay. That's why I gave you water.
You don't have me on time to do you.
You want me to read the question again and give you a break?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you have any ideas on how the city's economic development plan should be implemented?
Well, I think one of the things is working Chamber of Commerce with the Economic Development Council to pursue ideas through them. We need to work with our business people, the business community. Also getting input from the citizens. This is one of the things that is most frustrating about this job is that we have very little input from our citizens. We have workshops, we have a budget workshop, and nobody shows up. You know, we make these decisions on our own. So we kind of run these things out, we discuss them at workshops, and it's kind of up to the council to make a decision on what's the best route to take. But we're moving on. I think with the Dollar General store and the restaurant coming in, when we get the hotel open, those things are all going to trigger a more economic development. I think things will kind of piggyback from those.
Okay, great. And then the final question for you is, why do you want to serve on the city council?
Oh, that's a great question. One of the things is that I think that I bring that these other folks can't. They're working, and I'm retired, and I still have my mind is still active. I've still got a brain that I can use, and I enjoy it. I enjoy serving the community. I think we've done a lot of great things over the past 10 or 12 years. But I'm able to go to various council meetings. I represent the city at the Beach and Shores Restoration. I go to the Council of Local Governments down at Fort Pierce. That's a monthly meeting. I go to the Treasure Coast League of Cities. That's once every other, which is comprised of all of the government officials. The Treasure Coast League of Cities is just the cities within Indian River, St. Lucie, Martin, Okeechobee County. And these are great people to work with. These are the mayors and city council people. The Council of Local Governments is also comprised of the county commission and school board members. And we also have associate members like Florida Power & Light, AT&T, Waste Pro, Waste Management. So we get a lot of great ideas from networking with all these other people. And I can bring that back to the city. But I really enjoy it. I've been around here long enough. Just the historic value of having served. I know the projects that have started, where we are with it, and our vision for the future.
All right, great. Thank you very much. You guys did a great job.
Thank you.
And now you get to conclude. So we've kind of zipped through tonight, unless you want to throw any surprise questions.
Well, you have those extra questions if you want.
Do y'all want extra questions?
I would like to address some of the questions that you had before, like the difference between the strong mayor and a city manager form of government. Can I do that?
Yeah, I think we've got plenty of time. You guys okay with that? Yeah, we've got plenty of time. Please do that.
Well, when I first got on the council, we had a strong mayor. And Fellsmere was just sort of beginning to grow. We had, in that period of time, we annexed the what they call 3,500 acres of the ancient property. They were talking about an industrial development and residential housing out there, up in possibly 5,000 houses. And that was going to be a huge thing to manage, because in our development agreement, we had them to say if the county could not furnish water and sewer services, that the developer would put those facilities in and then deed them over to the city to operate. Well, during that time, I could see that we didn't have the expertise to do that. When I got elected to mayor, I was kind of told that I had to fire everybody in City Hall. You know, I was mandated to do that, to get rid of everybody in City Hall. Well, it took me about 15 minutes to realize I could not fire everybody in City Hall, because I didn't have a clue as to what I was supposed to do. Fortunately, we had John Little, who had been been city manager in Vero Beach for 25 years, and he kind of took me under his wing. And I learned how to be a mayor. But one of the things that I realized is that we need some professionalism. So John and I, the mayor, when he came back, he beat me by 10 votes and took back over again. I was out of a job, and then they fired John. So John and I got together and we said we need a city manager form of government. So we took the city charter from Vero Beach and Fellsmere and took the best parts of both of those and got it together, and we rewrote the charter and workshopped it. We came up with, I think there was 18 amendments to the charter. All of them passed except one. We had there was one that did not pass, and I couldn't even remember what it is now. But it passed by a margin of 77% from the citizens. And then we hired Jason, and the rest is history. And that's just the best thing that's ever happened, I think. I tell people that Jason has drug us kicking and screaming into the 21st century, really. And it's just, we are so fortunate to have somebody with his ability and his knowledge. He works constantly at it. He's out and about. He's well respected throughout the county. So that's the difference between when we had our strong mayor, nobody went to the county meetings. We were not represented down there. They shorted us on some of our tax revenue. They were doing all kinds of things. But nobody was down there to defend it. So anyhow, I'm glad I had an opportunity to explain.
Okay. Me too. That's great. Any of the rest of you
want to
address any of the other questions that you heard?
Yeah, one of the things that Joe mentioned about the audience, being in the city, I feel that they trust in us. I feel strong that if they, as councilors, they trust us, and I think we have a good time. Mm-hmm. And they are complimentary. A lot of reason they can't come because they work, they can't do the right thing for our city.
Okay. I'm reading the questions to see if I went through one to each of you. I'll throw this out to each of you and see if you want to answer it. And it'll be the same question to each. So to create a balanced budget for the city, what services would you reduce or taxes would you increase? And Mr. Tyson, I'll start with you. You've actually already addressed that you feel like the city's in good financial shape, but I don't know a lot about the city of Fellsmere personally, so maybe you can address if there are any services that you're concerned about or increases in taxes that you see coming in the future.
There's a couple of things, and we may be faced with that next year. If the economy doesn't turn around and we don't start getting more tax revenues in, then we may have to make some cuts. I think if we were gonna increase any taxes, I would probably start with the communication tax. That's one. Our utility taxes, we maxed out on utility taxes, but we would have to look at the any services that we give, like water and sewer and so forth. Those would have to come up a little bit. And then, of course, we might have to address the ad valorem. That's our chief source of revenue, which is the tax on property taxes. So those are the ones that I would have to kind of tinker around with it and see. You know, hold it to a minimum, but if you spread it out over all the property owners in the city, then it's kind of it's for everybody. Rather than decrease. The only other thing that we might do is contract out the like public works. That's we had talked about doing that several years ago. Have Fernando bring a lawn care service in.
And
take care of
that as next. Okay.
Ms. Solgado,
any
response to that one? Okay.
Mr. Herrera? I already passed it down. When it comes to taxes, you got to be careful today. I'd rather sit down with someone that has experience and I'd like to get more information on people.
Okay, no problem. Well, I'll ask one final question that's on here and I'll leave it up to you. Obviously, these are additional questions you weren't anticipating, so. What do you think is the most significant challenge to the business community of Fellsmere, and what can the city do to help them?
Say that again?
The most significant challenge to the business community here in Fellsmere, and what can the city do to help them?
compliments for that, because the winning economy is going, all the businesses are early to be back. Even I have a business myself too. Sometimes you have to work a little harder just to maintain your business. And right now, for the business, they just have to work a little harder and see what the economy is going to be down the road. Yeah, that's the way I look at it. I know it's hard for everyone, not just for even the people that go to work. It's a regular job, they have to budget everything. So to answer that, that's a tough one. Because of the economy, that people were, when Citrus was here, back in the 80s, Citrus was one of the big jobs. We have worked for everybody. Everybody had a good job. When Citrus going down, and that hurt the whole county.
I think trying to open a business, it's a challenge because you have to have certain amount of money to start from the beginning and get it set up to a little more to be. But with the economy, it's very hard.
Do you think that the city has a role? Do you have any ideas about, is there anything the city can do to help with that?
I mean, I think it would help. We don't know what way yet, but I mean,
you'll be learning.
Yes.
Okay. Mr. Tyson.
Well, one of the things that we did a couple of years ago when we had the first started the community development agency was we gave grants to people to enhance their signage, landscaping, paint their buildings. We were able to do that, but of course now with the reduction in revenue, we're about bankrupted our CRA fund until we could get that built back up. So we kind of put that on hold for a year. That's the biggest thing that I know of, other than maybe with an occupation license and things of that sort, we might be able to look at reducing some of those things to encourage prospective business.
Okay. All right, well, now I'll stop teasing you and I'll let you close. So, Mr. Herrera, you have 2 minutes to make a closing statement.
Okay, thank you. Well, first of all, I want to say thank you for coming out here. I was a councilman and resident of Fellsmere. I want to say thank you for coming out here and your support. The Chamber of Commerce, I want to thank you also for being so supportive for us. As a councilman, I love to continue being a councilman for the city of Fellsmere. I love the people, and as long as I get voted in, with your help, I'm continuing to do my best for our city, for the residents. And I always mention that as long as we stay focused, and respect from every resident in this community, we can go a long way. And then, and as a councilman, we work as a team. We have a wonderful city staff. You know, if we continue doing what we do, we'll be very successful in the city of Fellsmere. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Herrera. All right, Ms. Salgado.
I want to thank everybody here for coming and taking the time to listen to us. Also, I'm new, like everybody knows. So hopefully, if I do get elected, I'll learn more about the city and everything and hear what everybody has to say and try to see, work with, you know, the citizens here to try to make a better city.
All right, thank you. And Mr. Tyson.
Okay, again, I'd like to give the candidates, I thank you for coming out tonight, stormy weather and all, so. I'd like to continue serving. I had said a few years ago that by the time I turned 80, I would probably be dozing off at the council chambers and somebody would have to wake me up, but that hasn't happened. Like I said before, I've got the time to devote to the outside things as well as come to the county or to the city council meetings and the workshops and participate. I'm staying close contact with Jason and with the city clerk. Try to stay up on what's going on, and I still think I have some things to offer, and I would like to be able to continue on for two to four more years, and keep moving the city forward. That's our goal, and I think that's the goal of everybody. So I would appreciate your support, and again, thank you for coming out. Okay. And Teresa, thank you.
Oh, it was fun. I hope I get invited back. Okay, so our candidates forum is concluded. I want to thank our Chamber of Commerce and Beth Mitchell, our president, for hosting it, and also thank you to my committee that isn't here tonight, but the Legislative Government Affairs Committee of the Chamber, who helped write some of the questions, and I think we have some input from Beth on those as well, since she's a resident of your city. And we urge you guys to vote on November 6th, if not before, with early voting and absentee voting and all those things that you can do these days. And we just thank you for being here tonight. Good night.